Google's TensorFlow library is a great choice for building commercial-grade deep learning applications using Python. There's a lot of hype surrounding TensorFlow, so in this video, we're going to take a closer look and shed some light on the library's various features. TensorFlow grew out of an earlier Google library called DistBelief, which is a proprietary deep net library developed as part of the Google Brain project. The project team's vision was to build a system that simplified the deployment of large-scale machine learning models onto a variety of different hardware setups, anything from a smartphone to single servers to systems consisting of hundreds of machines with thousands of GPUs. In essence, this library would improve the portability of machine learning so that research models could be more easily applied to commercial-grade applications. Even though TensorFlow is only 6 months old, it's currently the most popular machine learning library on GitHub. Much like the Theano library, TensorFlow is based on the concept of a computational graph. In a computational graph, nodes represent either persistent data or a math operation, and edges represent the flow of data between nodes. The data that flows through these edges is a multidimensional array known as a tensor, hence the library's name TensorFlow. The output from one operation or set of operations is then fed as an input into the next. Even though TensorFlow was designed to support neural networks, it can support any domain where computation can be modeled as a data flow graph. TensorFlow also adopts several useful features from Theano, such as auto-differentiation, shared and symbolic variables, and common sub-expression elimination. And for an open-source library, it has comprehensive and informative documentation, in addition to a free, massive, open online course on Udacity as of March 2016. Different types of deep nets can be built using TensorFlow, although there is currently no support for hyperparameter configuration. TensorFlow has a roadmap that details some upcoming features, and while hyperparameter configuration is mentioned, there is no specific timeline for this feature's implementation. For now, TensorFlow users have to work with an additional library called Keras if this flexibility is required. Right now, TensorFlow has a no-nonsense interface for C++, and the team hopes that the community will develop more language interfaces through SWG, an open-source tool for connecting programs and libraries. Recently, Jason Toy of Somatic announced the release of a SWG interface to Ruby for the summer of 2016. You may have noticed that TensorFlow and Theano are very similar in many ways, but there are a few key differences. When TensorFlow was released in November of 2015, its compile and run times were several orders of magnitude slower than Theano, which was still a reported issue as recent as March 2016. The TensorFlow community, both the development team and outside contributors, have worked hard to combat these performance issues. Sumith Chintalo of Facebook regularly publishes updates on the performance of different libraries on GitHub. An update in April of 2016 showed that TensorFlow performed reasonably well in the ImageNet category, with no Theano-based libraries listed in the analysis. Another improvement over Theano comes in the form of parallelism. As we saw in a prior video, DeepLearning 4J supports the training of a machine learning model on a distributed framework through the use of a two-step procedure called iterative map reduce. The underlying concept, known as data parallelism, is implemented in a recent release known as Distributed TensorFlow, version 0.8. Data parallelism allows you to train different subsets of the data on different nodes in a cluster for each training pass, followed by parameter averaging and replacement across the cluster. Version 0.8 also implements model parallelism, where different portions of the model are trained on different devices in parallel. For example, you could use model parallelism to train stacked RNNs by deploying each RNN on a different device. Even though most deep learning libraries support CUDA, very few support OpenCL, a fast rising standard for GPU computing. In response to a top community issue currently open on this topic, the TensorFlow team has added OpenCL support to the roadmap. A nice feature is TensorBoard, a visualization tool for network architecture and performance. The tool allows you to zoom in and visualize different levels of the network, as well as view different summary level metrics and changes over time throughout the training process. TensorFlow has achieved significant results in the world of deep learning in a very short amount of time. If this trend continues, it is on track to become the premier library for building deep nets. In the next video, we'll take a look at metrics for deep learning.